For the past 5 years, we've been following the lives of independent Gothic artists in Salt Lake City whose contributions have made an impact on their community. These are not only individuals who are proud of their culture, but they also have a strong connection and underground network with other Gothic performing artists in their town. These are their lives. These are their stories. In order for us to appreciate the rich and yet sexy Gothic culture that we know and love today, it's best that we understand where it originated from. According to history, the Goths were Eastern Germanic tribes who in the 3rd and 4th centuries waged battle and conquered the Western Roman Empire. Most historians and scholars to this day have claimed that these Germanic tribes had originally migrated from Scandinavia. As for the East and North Germanic languages, which were contrasted with the earliest attestation, primarily from the Codex Argentus, a 6th century copy of the 4th century Bible translation, which was actually divided into three subgroups: Western Gothic, Eastern Gothic, and Crimanian Gothic. However, if researching ancient and extinct foreign languages just isn't your cup of tea, let it be known that the spawn of Gothic architecture started in the 12th century, originating in France, and became a style which flourished throughout Europe during the high and late medieval period. This Romanesque architecture lasted far into the 16th century and was known during the same period as the French style. The Gothic art scene in these ancient architectures was part of an art movement that lasted about 200 years. Concurrent with Gothic architecture found in these cathedrals, by the late 14th century it had evolved towards a more secular natural style known only as International Gothic, which continued until the late 15th century where it evolved into Renaissance art. The primary Gothic art mediums were sculptures, panel paintings, stained glass, and illuminated manuscripts. But it would still be hundreds of years later until the 1980s came around the corner, introducing Gothic rock bands that originally migrated from the United Kingdom coming out here to the United States with fancy trends of the Gothic subculture that we know in the world today. What started off as an offshoot to the post-punk genre, the Gothic subculture to this day has survived much longer than others of the same era. While it still continues to diversify our youth and society as its imagery and culture indicates influences from ancient Gothic artists from very long ago. We start off with an inspiring Gothic artist by the name of Jason Mast, who not only has interesting things to say about his artwork, but also the Gothic culture.
I have a lot of different roles in the community, like I've done tech support, I'm an artist now, I'm a professional artist, do shows at galleries. There's a whole lot of accomplishment that you can get out of doing that sort of thing. I'd like to have my business going pretty well, probably get a house, get a new car. It's given me sort of an opportunity that I didn't have before, because where I'm living right now, I've got like an actual studio. Because of that, I can actually pursue trying to make money as an artist, which I couldn't before. I mean, a lot of people play this game where they're just essentially trying to be fake people in order to get other people to like them more.
By 2006, Jason Mast was hired by the local Legacy Corporation for his skills as an artist to graphically design their Super Mexican character for publication. This was promoted at Comic-Con that same year, an annual event marketed towards comic book fans worldwide, which is held in San Diego, California.
Getting pissy outside just because of the fact that like they'd been waiting in line for like really long amounts of time. And they were not letting people in until they had let somebody else out. And I was just blown away by the whole thing. I mean, it's like thousands of people that are sitting outside in the sun waiting to come in here. Well, if I just walked through the door, and it did piss one guy off. This guy was like trying to block my way. He's like,
what?
Get in the line, you know. And so I showed him my badge, right? And he's like, what are you showing me that for? And then I walked right past him, and he like, you know, went nuts.
Thank you. Meanwhile, back in Salt Lake City, a local gothic band returns home for a short break after the uprising of their careers from their 2006 European tour. Their renown and credibility amongst their fans in the public eye know them only as Tragic Black.
I think the way that it is, the gothic scene and the metal scene, the alternative scene, the punk scene, it's really all like one ball of confusion. Gothic music and subculture should be whatever you want. I don't think it should be limited to black clothing. It shouldn't be limited to a certain style of music, a certain chord, a certain structure.
I think the biggest challenge that we face as independent artists is touring. To really get out there, we want to tour. I mean, we're a live band, you know, it's a very dynamic experience. But without money behind it, you know, like years and years ago before the record industry crashed, they would throw money behind a band and say, okay, go out on tour, you know, and they'd put you on tour with a big act that everybody knew, so people would come out and see you, and it's not like that anymore.
The way I got involved in the gothic scene was I had friends that were into it. They were coming to me at my place. They didn't really have anywhere to go, and it was the same old thing, and they were tired of it. So I was considering having a gothic night at my place, Easy Street. What I like about it, the people that are into it they're really into the music. They're passionate about their style. A lot of their music is like a nostalgic throwback to the 80s. A lot of good music came out of the 80s. Able to take the best of that era and combine it with the newer music that's out there that just didn't have back then. It creates such an interesting, unique style.
How has the gothic movement changed in the past 4 years of my life? People used to mainly focus on the bars, and now they go other places and do other things. Some of the younger people that are coming into the scene, 18-year-olds and such, a lot of people got an interesting, different take on things, and change is good. That one right there, I've always kind of liked a lot of road paintings, just because I've driven a lot. And these are all, like, actual people. Oh, well, that's Vile. He doesn't quite dress like that anymore, but that's his little thing. Right here, Vile with Tragic Black, yeah. There was actually sort of an interaction that happened on a dance floor. I'm a little bit fascinated by that. This girl right here was kind of... Vile was like dancing around, and she was kind of dancing up next to him, and then he hits on everybody. That's the thing, you know? And so it was just, people were entertaining around it, and there were several people trying to ignore it.
That's what I love about Salt Lake City. More like when we tour, spend time in Europe, it's like you come back home for us. If I could change anything in the gothic scene, it would be the ignorance. I don't like it when people are like, this guy's got the wrong color hair, this guy's not got enough makeup, this guy...
It's like any other scene. I mean, you have the scene warriors that think that they know like what the epitome of it is, and then they go around and judge everybody else.
I'm trying to think about how people cause conflict and like confusion and drama in their lives, because like all the snow people are kind of fighting at each other, and like you can see that the one... Like there's snow people that are like yelling at the other ones, and then you know there's ones that have got their hands thrown up, you know, it's all under a church. I mean, it's kind of me thinking about society, really.
People associate things with, you know, your appearance so much. It's an automatic assumption. People will look at you and they will, you know, they'll drop you in a category real quick.
A lot of places like Berlin, they've got these empty like warehouses from World War II still, you know? And you know what happens when you go inside?
Sectors of the city.
You walk in these places and you've got artists living in these blown up buildings.
They have like
they have nothing else to do.
Like, they have advertised on the outside of the building. I am a squatter. I am living in this.
It's seriously beautiful, because these old things that, you know, the government can't use and these corporations can't use, you've got starving people making homes in them.
Right now I'm at Salt Lake City's Liberty Park. Here you'll find director of Incendiary Circus, Jody Smalley, practicing before every performance before they go out into the public and entertain a crowd.
I also know that you have an outfit like this. How come you didn't wear it? We just finished sweeps.
Well, I was a little bit cold today, but...
This is one way to warm up, Danny Carey, but again, we don't recommend that you try this at home.
Now,
Why didn't we have this yesterday?
That's pretty impressive.
No.
Yeah, I'm the director of Incendiary Circus. Kind of an anomaly here in Utah. I mean, I've been to LA, I've been to Vegas. I mean, my mentor who taught me fire breathing, he's been performing in Vegas since he was 13. You know, so I've been out there and performed, and he's like, you only get paid that much per gig? I mean, you should be at least getting this. And I'm like, well, there is a little bit of a, you know, a price difference in cost of living here between Salt Lake and Vegas, you know, so you can take that into an account. But, you know, when you have been performing for 5 years and learning and growing your skill and everything, and then you have this company or organization contact you and say, hey, we'll give you $20 to come and spend, you know, to come and perform for 2 hours, you know, it's a little disrespectful. What it is of the Gothic community in Japan that I find to be interesting is, it's like a lot of the girls at that time, they were into like the Lolita, like the doll, you know, Southern Belle kind of dresses, you know, the ruffly caps and the curl wigs and everything. You know, the big poofy kind of dresses. There's definitely an anime, Japanese animation influence there. They definitely have like anime flair. You know, the guys especially.
I'm standing outside Salt Lake City's Area 51. Area 51 opened their doors to the public in 1998. Originally marketed towards the Gothic nightlife while creating nonprofit organizations like the Dark Arts Festival that run each year from June 6th through June 8th. Now in 2008, they're celebrating their 10-year anniversary in business while people from all walks of life come downtown to enjoy the Area 51 environment.
Did I do anything to draw the Gothics here? I've been involved in the goth and industrial scenes for a long time, so I had a natural, you know, connection with most of them. Having the 18-year-old section is great because it gives people a chance to get into the scene a little bit earlier than they normally would, while they're still curious about things and they'll have the chance to hear new music. Plus, it provides a place for those people to go. If we're one of the only clubs that has 18 and over.
However, some skeptics and independent artists in Salt Lake City tend to disagree with Area 51's style of entertainment.
Yeah, Area 51 was the only place in town that people could go to. It's pretty much been the only place that's stuck around for a decade at least. And it looks exactly the same as the day it opened. The same old, same old. They call it the Area 51 soundtrack. Now, if you're not moving forward, you know, you're moving backwards. If they want new experience. Life is about experiencing new things.
When you have several thousand people a week coming through your establishment and, you know, it's hot and people are drinking and having a fun time, you're gonna have some problems. Interestingly enough, it's actually the Gothic and industrial people, they rarely ever have caused the problems. I mean, not in 10 years. It's always the other crowds. I mean, the rule of thumb is the freakier somebody looks, the less likely they are to actually cause a problem here, which you think would be the opposite. You know?
The entertainment industry in this town is run by businessmen. It's not run by entertainers. Area 51, for example, you know, and it becomes about selling alcohol. People get sick of that. I mean, it's not an experience. You do that once or twice and you want something new.
However, most people desire to look at the Area 51 situation. Not all nightlife business owners have ended with the same amount of success.
While Nate Hansen says Easy Street is not a business, in the city's eyes, it is. The city also says it's a death trap. Here's why. Inside Easy Street, it's easy to see why some consider this a club.
Some people come here thinking it's a club just because of how much I put into the place. So they probably would let down their guard because they would expect certain safety precautions to have been taken.
Box 13 was there when the fire marshal and city inspectors showed up at Easy Street.
That's a business and we need to go in and we need to make sure he's safe.
They say the warehouse isn't up to fire code with tangled extension cords like this, a huge fire hazard everywhere. There's no sprinkler system, just one fire extinguisher in the whole place.
The exits aren't well lit, there aren't emergency lights, there's no fire extinguishing system, there's no smoke detection system.
And when fire officials heard about this, fire fire dancers joining the party, tossing flames without a permit.
Anybody inside?
Haunting flashbacks of what happened at a Rhode Island nightclub came racing back.
What they're doing is they're cheating everybody out of safety to make a buck.
He says it is putting a cease and desist order on the property, as they are asking Hansen to vacate the property, and it will eventually be torn down.
When you're having a good time, from your experience, you want to be aware of what's going on. Yeah, when the fire marshal came into my place, she was legitimately, you know, concerned for fire safety. Yeah, the other fire marshal, when I saw that, I was being associated with probably things that he'd experienced. He'd never met me. He'd never been to my place. He didn't know what I was about or what I was doing. To say that I was motivated by money at the expense of safety, like, I'd like to show that guy my bank account right now. If I'm motivated by money, you know, where is it? You know, like, I don't have a dime to my name. This one fire in Rhode Island that happened, what, 6 years ago? It's the only one everyone's ever heard of. Yeah, it was this band that just showed up, didn't even tell anyone, and they were lighting off fireworks inside this club. You know, 100 people died. I felt like I'd inspired a lot of people. I made people believe in something good again. And to have it go away, it was very personal. People had given up on community, they'd given up on being able to express themselves. A lot of good people, they were tired of being ostracized and treated like they don't belong. Easy Street made people comfortable in an environment where they could be unique.
Salt Lake City, home to several people who make a difference with their artistic passions meant to impact mankind while under the ridicule of others in life. Others who believe that it's easier to hate someone for what they represent than it is to tolerate their differences. But if we learn anything from these Gothics, it's that they teach us the best way to keep those people from having power over you is to refuse those others in society your attention. I'm Dante Antonio Dominguez, and the rest here in 2008 is history.
I'm here with Area in the 12th century period. We'll do that one again. We better wait for them to eat that. Right now I'm at Salt Lake City's Sugar House Park. I mean Liberty Park. I'm right here with, what's your name again? testing. I am not Bob Ross.
There you go. As they collapse.